Hi, welcome to today's tutorial. Today we will be learning how to draw and paint this girl wearing this particular jacket. So using a 300 GSM sketchbook, I am going to first draw out my character. I normally begin with creating the guidelines and then I very lightly draw out the features, decide the height of the character that I'm going to draw and very lightly create the hairstyle. Now, if you're a beginner and you ended up drawing this little dark, then before you start your painting, make sure that you lighten the entire thing, either run your eraser over it lightly so that just the basic details are seen. Otherwise, the lines will be very darkly visible through your watercolor paintings as they are translucent. You can decide the style of jacket you want to create. It could be very simple with very basic sleeves. I'm creating puff sleeves over here and I'm also drawing out the hands and the length of my drawing. So I'm erasing all the extra lines which are not needed and making sure that all my guidelines are also erased off. I'm not drawing the hands and the palms because I want the character to be seen only till where the jacket is there. So I'll start out with creating the details for the face. I'm using this particular color palette from Art Philosophy. It's called Pastel Dreams. Please feel free to create and use any color palette that you have. You don't have to necessarily have the same brown color for the face. You can go with a light orange, you can go with a light pale pink, you can go with blue. If you want to create a really fictional character by yourself, then please go ahead and use it the way you want. You can begin by creating a light base color and then using a darker shade of it, create the shadow towards the left side. So here I'm mixing a light pink for my jacket and then I'm going to use a slightly darker color on the edges wherever the shadow falls. You can see here how adding a little bit of shadow brings the entire jacket to life. You can start seeing the mini details like the puff on the sleeves, the lapel shape. So it's very important for us to do this step. So it's very easy. Like I said earlier, the first stage is going to be a lighter shade. The second stage will always be a slightly darker shade. To mix it for the lighter color, use a little bit more water, and for the darker color, use a little bit lesser water. I'm using some black for my hair. Feel free to use any color that you want for your hair. I'm going ahead with the same style where I'll color the base first and then while it's still wet, I'll use a slightly darker shade. You can still create another layer over it if your base layer has dried completely. You might need to use a little bit more water to gradate it. That's all. Now that my watercolor painting is filled in the entire drawing that I have created, I'm switching over to a miniature brush to add in some more details like my hair accessories, and I'm going to now add the outline. So here in this case, I'm using a miniature brush to create the outline. In case you don't have a very small round brush, then you can use your micron pens, or once the entire thing is dried, use a regular black pen to add in the details. Now, another thing that you could do over here is for each section, you can use a darker color of that same object that you're painting in. For example, over here, I could use a dark pink to create the outline for my jacket. Smaller details like this are very hard to achieve unless you have the right brush. So in case you don't have it, please leave out these tiny details such as the puff strokes in the sleeve and then the small elbow cuts and also the face details. So for all of these things, you can switch over to a pen or you could even use your pencil to create these details on it. Here I'm adding some patterns on my collar. using black for my face features. You can also switch over for the different parts of the face. For example, for your eyes, you can still use black. For your nose, you can use a dark brown. And for your lips, you could just use pink. Now that my avatar is ready, I am going to color in the background. I'm going to use a nice sky blue to create the background. I'm going to leave a little bit of edge around this drawing and then fill in. Now this is something that I personally like creating. You don't necessarily have to create a background this way, but if you are not able to create it in the first go, you could create the white space. You can just create a border line using your pencil and then fill in the rest of the area. For this, I'm using a round brush. These kind of smaller paintings, I always prefer to use a round brush as compared to a flat brush. I hope you had a good time creating this. Do follow me on Instagram and tag me over there so I can see it, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.